Okay, fair. So you constructed this yourself, eh?
Yeah, I this local myself.
Okay.
Laying the blocks. That's all you need to just get the size you want.
Okay.
And these rods with the wools.
Okay.
I made them by myself.
So this one, roughly, how many fishes can you smoke at a time on it?
I can get 150 pieces of fish on this smoker.
Oh, okay.
Dry your fish, you have to clean them, okay. Remove all the guts. It's okay. A whole process. You don't just catch the fish from your pond and you put them on fire.
Oh, okay.
You need to remove the guts in them, clean the slime on them, wash them thoroughly in a hygienic condition since it's going for market.
Okay.
You don't want somebody to eat your fish and have a bad comment about it.
Oh, okay.
So you always have to do the needful to make sure you produce your products in a hygienic condition.
Okay, so that is for the smoker, as you can see.
So this is my smoker, and I have 80 pieces of fish.
Okay.
On the smoker right here.
Okay, at the moment there is 80 pieces. Okay. Those ones are ready.
They are not ready, but I'll bring them up and I'll send them down.
Those ones down. To the down. Okay.
For them to also get the heat to dry well.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So basically, when you smoke it like this,
yeah.
And then when you sell it fresh, which one is more profitable?
Well, in terms of profitability, I would say selling your fish fresh,
okay,
is much profitable. You don't have to dry. To dry your fish, you need fuel.
Okay.
You need to buy firewood. Either you use gas,
okay,
or whatever means you use to dry your
fish,
and that also comes with another cost.
Okay.
But to sell your fish fresh, just to catch from the pond,
okay,
you clean them, you give it to your customer.
Then you are good to go.
And some customers also buy it alive.
So okay.
Depending on the service, you are good to go. But selling your fish fresh is the best way.
Okay.
Drying it is just adding more value to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see. All right.